Stratified sampling is a method used by researchers to ensure that their sample accurately reflects the diversity of the population by focusing on key subgroups or strata. The basic idea is that the population is divided into distinct groups based on important characteristics such as age, gender, income level, education, or ethnicity. Once these groups are defined, participants are then randomly selected from each stratum. This approach allows researchers to ensure that the sample mirrors the proportions of these subgroups in the overall population, leading to more precise and reliable findings. For example, if a population consists of 40% males, 55% females, and 5% transgender people, the researcher ensures that the sample has the same proportional representation. This method is particularly effective in studies where the population consists of individuals with varying characteristics that could influence the outcome of the study. By ensuring that all relevant subgroups are proportionally represented, stratified sampling helps the researchers avoid overrepresenting or underrepresenting certain groups. One of the main strengths of stratified sampling is its ability to produce a highly representative sample of the population. By ensuring that each subgroup is properly represented, this method increases the precision of the results, which in turn improves the reliability of the study's findings. This is especially important in research where differences between subgroups are a key focus. Moreover, by dividing the population into strata and then randomly selecting participants from each group, stratified sampling ensures a more balanced and accurate representation, which minimizes the risk of sampling errors. Finally, the ability to analyze subgroup differences is a key advantage of stratified sampling, particularly in fields like sociology, economics, and public health, where understanding these differences is critical. While stratified sampling offers many advantages, it does come with certain challenges, particularly in terms of the time and resources required to implement it. One of the most time-consuming aspects of this method is the need to define and organize the strata before selecting participants. Researchers must have a clear understanding of which characteristics are most relevant to the study and must have detailed information about the population to create the strata. Furthermore, in some cases, this information may not be readily available, or the population may be too complex to neatly divide into well-defined strata. Stratified sampling can also be more logistically complicated than simpler methods like convenience sampling. Researchers need to ensure that they have enough participants in each stratum to allow for meaningful analysis, which can require more recruitment efforts. If some strata are smaller or harder to reach, the researcher may need to put in extra effort to find participants from those groups, increasing both time and costs. Given its ability to provide a highly representative sample, stratified sampling is best used in studies where representation across key subgroups is critical. It is particularly useful when researchers are interested in analyzing differences between subgroups, such as age, income, or geographic location. Stratified sampling is also valuable in demographic studies, where the goal is often to understand the characteristics of various subgroups within a population.